Planet Dolan. Can nukes be created at room temperature? Did humans really originate in Asia? Here are 15 things science got totally wrong at some point. I'm Danger Dolan's mysterious brother, and today I'll be your narrator. Number 15. A tongue has taste zones. For much of the 20th century, it was believed that your tongue separated different tastes such as sweetness, sourness, and bitterness using different areas. It was suspected that the taste buds were a bit like the red, green, and blue color cones in your eyes. Each one could only detect one specific input. It's not true. Every taste bud registers every taste. The idea actually spread through bad reporting and diagrams. Harvard psychologist Edwin G. Boring used the work of a German scientist, which said that some areas of the tongue are more sensitive to certain tastes, not that they could only sense one taste. But this wasn't made clear. This misunderstanding led to a tongue map that lasted from 1901 to the 70s. Number 14. Planet Vulcan. A lot of the science of space involves watching little dots and seeing how they move. So when Mercury was seen to have a little wobble in its orbit, we believed it was due to another planet dragging it out of its stable solar orbit. We named this planet Vulcan, and there were even reported sightings of it. Then Einstein came along and explained it was actually the enormous gravity of the sun that was bending space-time and so causing the wobble. Number 13. Humorism. The Greeks and Romans had a detailed approach to medicine, just it was one based off completely false theory. Humorism believed that people are basically just walking bits of plumbing, and all illnesses were caused either by too much or too little of one of the four internal humors, or liquids. These were black bile, yellow bile, phlegm, and blood. Their influence lasted a long time, since the practice of leeches and bloodletting all have a root in humorism, and they were still commonly practiced in the 19th century. Number 12. Homunculus. Although mankind has been having sex for our entire existence, it's only very recently that we understood how it works. One early theory was that a tiny but mostly formed human lived within a sperm cell. The little sperm person was called a homunculus. The male homunculus would also have sperm of its own. Some people also thought this explained why when Adam was damned in the Garden of Eden, all mankind was also damned because he held the entire world in his testicles. Like if the movie Inception was about balls. Number 11. Cold fusion. Nuclear fission is about the splitting of an atom. It's how we generate nuclear power, and it requires dangerous elements and produces radioactive waste. But nuclear fusion is the combining of atoms. It produces much more energy and clean waste. The problem is, it needs enormous heat to get started, tens of millions of degrees. But in 1989, Stanley Pons and Martin Fleischmann claimed to have achieved cold fusion at room temperature. No one has been able to recreate their so-called results, so it's been dismissed as junk science, but people are still trying to do the same thing today. Number 10. Aether. At the end of the 19th century, we knew that light was a wave, but that didn't explain how it could travel through empty space. Waves need something to travel through, like surf waves on the ocean or sound waves through the air. So we came up with the luminiferous aether, the medium of empty space, but it was basically the same as empty space, as it had no interaction with physical objects. The theory of relativity put an end to aether. Number 9. Various atomic theories. One area that we've been wrong over and over again is what the hell is happening down in Atomic Town. The idea of atoms being the building blocks of the universe is very old. Democritus first came up with the idea in ancient Greece, saying there were different shapes depending on the material. Iron atoms must have hooks to make them connect strongly, while water atoms were slippery. For a while we thought electrons orbited a solid nucleus, although now we know that the nucleus is made up of protons and neutrons. And then we worked out that protons and neutrons were made of even smaller parts called quarks. But quarks are the smallest. I mean, definitely. Right, guys? Are we sure? Number 8. Out of Asia. Once Darwin's theory of evolution had become widely accepted, and that man and ape shared a common ancestor, a new question arose. Where did the first humans come from? Until the middle of the 20th century, most anthropologists were confident that humans originated in Asia. This was mostly because of the discovery of skeletons in Java and China that were over 750,000 years old. However, we're now confident that humanity began in Africa thanks to a huge analysis of skulls. It was found that the further from Africa you went, the less genetic diversity there was, meaning it's very likely it was the origin point. Number 7. Terra Australis. Before the land we now know as Australia was discovered, many voyagers and cartographers believed there must be a huge landmass in the southern hemisphere to balance those in the north. They named it Terra Australis, and it appeared on maps before any European had ever been there. It covered the whole southern pole, all the way down to where Australia is now. When Captain Cook discovered a southern landmass, it was named Terra Australis, and then later Australia. We also mistakenly believed it was the most southern landmass until the Arctic proved us wrong again.
Number 6.
Phrenology. In the mid-19th century, phrenology became extremely popular. The basic idea was that the brain was made up of many separate organs, each one controlling a part of your personality. Also, the bigger the brain, the more brain power you had. Practitioners could run their fingers over a person's head and try to read their personality from the shape.
Number 5.
A zoic hypothesis. In 1843, a naturalist called Edward Forbes put forward a theory that no life would exist in the sea below 300 fathoms. That's about 550 meters to any of you land people. He didn't just pull this number from nowhere though. He took samples at various depths and showed how the frequency of life decreased. It was believed the pressure would be far too high for living beings. But in the 1860s, specimens were found at 450 fathoms. And then, to seal the deal, all the way down to 2,345 fathoms, over 4 kilometers beneath the surface.
Number 4.
Emission of vision. In ancient Greece, many people believed that our eyes contained a fire of their own, and vision was possible because light shone out from inside you onto the objects you were looking at. It's likely the origin came from seeing the highly reflective eyes of animals like cats. One of the earliest light scientists, Euclid, rejected the whole idea, which was very sensible of him.
Number 3.
Classical elements. Long before any kind of atomic theory, Western civilization believed everything was composed of the 4 natural elements: earth, air, fire, and water. In Japan, however, they added a 5th known as void. This is similar to the aether we already mentioned, but was really a description of pure energy beyond our control or understanding.
Number 2.
Catastrophism. Before the 19th century, most scientific thought was tied closely to religious belief. In the West, this meant that the creation story led us to believe the Earth was quite a new thing. So, we believed most natural features were created by sudden global events like flooding or earthquakes. It's called catastrophism, the idea that major catastrophes shape the planet rather than the reality, that it's a mind-bogglingly slow process.
Number 1.
Miasmatic theory of disease. For a long time, we thought that disease was caused by poisonous vapors in the air that you could detect through foul smells. It's called miasma theory, and you can see its influence in the naming of malaria, from the Italian mal, bad, and aria, air. The theory gained a lot of weight during industrialization, when the stinking cities were full of the sick and disease, which is understandable and not entirely untrue since the pollution was very harmful.
Well, that's it for this countdown, but catch you guys next time!